There seems to be some activity in the American camp.
The ice cream shipment must have arrived.
They might attempt an advance.
At full moon.
The Americans are not very bright. Is your unit ready?
My wolves are always ready and always hungry.
The key to our strategy is M Battery. You and your wolves must protect those guns. Understand?
Herr Oberst, it's as good as done.
All right, Major, what about these guns? What about this M battery of theirs? They control the entire sector. They're the key to the whole damn situation. We get them out of there tonight, or the tank advance, and the whole Operation Red Devil will be called off. And I'm not prepared for 1 minute to do that.
I know, General. I have a unit of commandos. Demolition experts. They're ready. This is what we've mapped out for them. They'll drop here, at the Oasis. Sheikh Faisal, our ally, will meet them. The unit will split into two squads. The first will lay mines along this line in case there are any German patrols in the area. This first squad will then move back into these ruins behind the Oasis. They'll act as rear cover for the second squad, the demolition team, which will be guided by Sheikh Faisal from the drop point, past these ruins, and up these hills, along the plateau, right to the precipice. They'll lower one man to place the charges, haul him up.
Oh, it's as tough a way to get to those guns as you could find, but it's the only way. Any other approach is in their way back over the plateau, down the hills, pretty much the same way they came, and rendezvous with squad. They'll wait for the main force.
There, they'll all join up with the general attack at dawn.
Who's in charge?
George Vincent.
Good. Get them going.
Hey, Sarge, Captain wants you.
Another 20 minutes, Kelp.
Yes, sir.
I want the men on the firing range at 1,500 hours.
All right, sir.
Captain Vincent, the Major wants you at the CP now.
Got it. All right, take over, Kelp.
Yes, sir. Captain, I hope it's a mission. The men are getting a little rested.
Yeah.
Our tanks must advance by 0300 hours. Can you knock out that battery by then?
Full moon.
That's why we move tonight. The Germans won't be expecting us.
Where's the drop?
Here, south of the battery hill, there are these old ruins. You'll come down beside them. In case you're spotted, you'll have some protection.
We've contacted our friend Sheikh Faisal. He'll try and meet you at the drop point and head you in the right direction.
The code name for your operation is Red Devil. Good luck.
Yeah.
Sergeant, I'm worried.
Impossible.
Why impossible?
For worrying, you need a brain, which you don't have.
What's worrying you, Steve?
We gotta ride camels. Boy, I don't want no part of them. Do you know what camels can do to you?
Man, this is it.
To Minchin. Wolf to Minchin.
This is Minchin. Come in.
Americans have landed. Paratroops near M Battery. Warn M. Suggest scout plane check on American movements. We are ready to advance. Over and out.
Which one of you is Captain Vincent?
I am.
Assalamu alaikum. You must hurry. Listen. German scouts. Very dangerous.
بسرعة.
بلاسكي. أبرامز.
جهز نفسك.
يانيني. Come with me. The rest of you men will stay with Kelp. You've got to stop those Germans at the ruin.
Well, where do we meet?
If we make it, we'll meet you before daylight. Mm.
Come on, boys.
Battery's over there. Keep to the right of the dune and take the gully below. It will lead you to the south side of the hill. The climb is very steep, but the Germans will not be looking for you there. Allah prosper your journey, sir.
Yalla, Erjan.
We shall proceed on a line towards the ruin. Watch for my signal.
All dead, sir.
All right, we'll move on. Hurry it up. Take cover.
Get their cars. That way.
pick up the cars.
Send this message. Urgent.
Headquarters to Alpha Tank Command. Proceed with Operation Red Devil. Proceed with Operation Red Devil.
American tanks. Hundreds of them. Advancing to our lines. Grid coordinates 212-466.
Get those map coordinates to Battery M at once. Alert all units. 12th Panzers to move. Advance for the fort and support.
Yes, yes. Understood. Repeat grid bearing. 212-466.
Wilco and out. All tank units are waiting on the perimeter outside the German gun battery's maximum range of fire. They're waiting orders to advance. That's all.
Nothing new?
No, sir, nothing. The plane came back, sir. The pilot says the drop went off without a hit.
Why can't we make radio contact?
Too risky. Might give the game away.
If Vincent doesn't come through in 30 minutes, we'll have to cancel our attack.
Enemy units are halted out of range. 226571.
I think we got him all our Hauptmann.
Good.
Keep firing, same grid bearing. At least we'll keep them home tonight.
Ausschließen.
Americans. But let's see the color of their blood when they face the wolves.
Order a full-scale attack. Those Germans are going to find our tanks breathing up their alley by sunup.
Counterattack. Immediately, Herr General.
Well, what do you know? Kelp outfoxed the Krauts.
Okay, nothing.
is under cover. Let's go.
Cave, sir. You're in the cave.
Where's our gun? Where is it?
We had to leave it behind.
They'll blow us to bits if we don't find cover.
Yeah. I'll be able to look after myself. Well, you go and get it.
Kelp! Move! Move! Let's go!
You and your men kindly face me and put your hands up so that my men can disarm you.
Ready! Remove arms, knives, whatever they have. Lothar, shell!
My dear Captain, George Vincent, is it? Permit me to introduce myself. I'm Captain Heinrich Meinecke. You gave us quite a chase last night.
I said one of my men was hurt out there.
Where?
Outside the entrance.
Lost the bat.
Yeah, yeah.
You Americans control the area.
Ja, Herr Hauptmann.
You know nothing, understand?
Ja, Herr Hauptmann. No, Herr Hauptmann. Yes, sir.
Captain Vincent, your man is lying in the sand 100 feet from the entrance. I believe he's still alive.
I'd like permission to get him.
I have your word and the word of your men that you will not try to escape, Captain.
Help, Captain!
You got ours, Captain.
You have it.
Gefreiter!
Sir?
Help the captain and his sergeant bring back the wounded American.
Yes, sir.
There he is!
Master!
Miller, first aid kit. Willie, get a fire going, fast.
Delp, get the water. Giannini, cut off a piece of your shirt. Need a cloth.
God verdammt! Do I have to be an American to get any attention? Or do I sit here and bleed to death? Get off it!
You make so much noise because you're not hurt, Pat. So take off your shoes and pull up your pants.
Take off my shoes? What do you mean, take off my shoe? I can't risk taking off my shoe in case my foot falls off with it.
Get the aid kit.
This is, how do the English put it, heaping coals of fire on the head of your enemy. Do you enjoy war, Captain?
Does anybody?
Of course. The manufacturers of ammunition, politicians hungry for power, adventurers, thugs, many enjoy war.
Do you?
The bite of bitter, the English say. It was my question, Captain.
I was teaching. I could have continued, stayed out of the war. But after the Japs bombed Pearl Harbor, I figure if you don't fight back when your home's being attacked, you're not much of a man. How about you?
For us, this war is a matter of honor for the German people. Righting the wrongs of the First War. Bringing a new order to Europe. This is our great struggle against the anarchy of communism. You know that, Captain, don't you? I went from the Hitler Jugend to the Wehrmacht.
from Austria to Africa. And I believed in it, every moment of it.
Here now, talking to you, my enemy, a man I must kill. I've been disciplined to that. Then I begin to wonder.
Captain.
Take it easy, Pete. You're going to be all right.
You know I won't. I can't stand it, Captain. Pain's too much. I'll never make it.
We'll have you to a doctor first thing in the morning, Pete. You'll be as good as new.
Let me out of my misery, Captain. I'll go mad. Finish me off, Captain. Finish me, I beg you. Damn it, Dale.
You've got the guns.
You don't think much of us Germans, do you, Captain? Bent.
Jawohl.
The wounded American is dying. He asks to be put out of his misery. Shoot him.
Can't do it, sir.
Soldier. Sergeant. We'll have to make a run for it. We have no food, very little water. Conserve what we have.
Where are we heading?
Frankly, Captain, I'm not sure. We'll make for where our units were yesterday. Your people could be there today.
You're taking a hell of a gamble. Sandstorm coming up. No compass?
Yeah, a very great gamble. The alternative seems to be to stay here and die of thirst. I'm sure you have no objection, Captain.
You got the votes.
Think you can make it?
I'm okay, Captain. Gangrene is set in, but what's the difference?
Thank you. You fool! Put that away! I'll tell you when to drink. Our guns, ammunition, stripped down. What good are they now? Only a burden.
Right.
But I must remind you, Captain, you and your men are still my prisoners.
Prisoners and their captors. What difference does it make, Germans? Americans. We're all the same now.
Throw away your guns and ammunition. Everything you can. We carry nothing. At least that way we can go. All right, let's move on. Time to rest by the truck.
Reminded of beach in Maine.
There's a lake at Passa.
Must be going out of our heads.
Hauptmann! Herr Hauptmann! Look!
Stop! Wait!
I see what it is, sir!
Stop, you fool! That's a minefield! Stop!
Have a map of your minefields, Captain. American efficiency.
Jesus Christus.
What the hell?
It's a false map. Leave it, Captain. It's a false one we planted for you to pick up.
Herr Hauptmann.
Yeah?
I know these minefields. They work in triangles. Three mines, each triangle. Take the fuse off one, the others won't work. Not difficult, sir.
If you know what you're doing. If you don't.
Herr Hauptmann, the men in your company always know what they're doing. And if they don't, they try it anyway.
Is it the key mine?
That we find out. There's your triangle, sir. You'll make it. Now.
My countrymen, my countrymen,
you hit the jackpot. Mueller was right. You made it.
What do I do with you?
No problem. If your men are there, then my men must be in that direction. A patrol pick us up.
What do I do with myself now? We drag through hell to find my people. We find them, and I'm afraid to go to them. I was trained to kill. To kill any man who wears that uniform. With everything in me, I believed that. You're my prisoners.
Yeah, we sure are.
Go away. I don't want to see your faces. You American pigs. Why did you help me? Why did I help you?
I'll see you, fella. In Berlin.
I'll meet you again, Captain.
Not in this war, buddy.
And I'll kill you for what you killed in me.
Go it now, Captain.
We'll head north.
Why north?
That's the way to Berlin, soldier.
Präsentiert das Gewehr. Rührt euch. Achtung. Rührt euch.
Herr Major, an English aircraft will shut down near Strasbourg.
Come to my office.
Jawohl.
Mahler. A Wehrmacht officer should know that information of this nature is not for the ears of everybody and anybody.
Ja, Herr Major, I'm sorry, sir.
Very well. Now, what is it?
This message just came in from headquarters, sir.
Read it.
An English bomber was shot down last night over Colmar. The crew was captured. A full interrogation is ordered since our intelligence reports that one of the prisoners is a colonel with the Allied High Command, not an airman, and known to possess highly classified information. Major Heinrich Meinecke is assigned responsibility for said interrogation.
Where are the prisoners now?
On the way, sir. By truck with an escort.
There's a shelter down the road. Let's halt.
They're too important. They want it now at headquarters.
Ah.
Beeilt euch.
Now, chaps, have you all got it straight? There's no colonel here. We never heard the name Steele.
And a good thing, that.
Stow it, Smith. How do I explain these trousers?
Scared out your blooming pants, you was.
Smith!
Sir?
Not sir, either. The name is Lyon.
Yes, sir, Lyon.
Oh, don't make him sound like a species of steak, Smith. Point is, mum's the word. We've got to bluff him. Understand?
Right. Alfie.
Splendid. Now let's pitch this coat and belt overboard.
Father, I was so worried.
You worry too much. You're like your mother.
Well, somebody has to worry, Father. There were some German soldiers here again today. I'm sure they suspect you already.
This is a thing I must do, Janine.
Assemble your men at once and be ready to move out at a moment's notice. As soon as we've heard from our French radio contact, you'll move out. And good luck, Vincent.
Thank you.
afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon, sir.
You're welcome here. I hope your trip was not too uncomfortable.
Jolly sight better than English trains, sir.
Thank you.
Smith, sir.
Thank you, Smith. I see your arm is hurt.
I'll send my medical officer to have a look at it. Anybody else? Ah, you're wounded too. Guard? Order the medical officer to come down right away.
All happened.
You'll be well fed, gentlemen. Ask for what you want. If we have it, you're welcome to share it. Now then, which one of you is the colonel? It will be much to your advantage if you speak up now. Is it you? Are you?
Hmm? What about me, sir?
Welcome to you, Smith. Naturally, I can see years of Eton and Sandhurst written all over you. There is, I must tell you, a Gestapo officer on my staff. He's burning with a desire to interrogate you in his own manner. I hope you'll cooperate, gentlemen. He's a determined man, and shall we say, ruthless. Gentlemen?
Calling Devil, calling Devil.
Lucifer, this is Devil, over.
Bulma!
Call Major Monica, we've got him.
Prisoners taken to Wehrmacht camp 241. Action urgent tonight. Over.
Roger. Where's the contact point? Over.
The meeting is set. St. Boniface Church. Before dawn. Over.
Roger. Over and out.
Pinpoint the position of that transmitter if it takes you all night. Tell Marla to stand by with a car and four motorcycles. I'll be in my office.
Everything's ready, Major.
Let's move it.
Again, who are you?
Flight Lieutenant Charles Wingham, RAF.
That's better. And which man is the Army Colonel?
What Army Colonel?
This gonna be a tough one, Major?
Impossible.
Well, it takes a little longer, that's all.
Lammy's lost a bomber last night.
Happens all the time.
Not like this. Inside the plane was an Army colonel named James Steele.
What makes him special?
South of here, the Germans are developing a new secret weapon. It's bigger than the V-2 or anything else. Now, our whole front has shifted position to get at it. This Colonel Steele is supposed to be an expert on the overall picture. We need him. Real special.
Okay, man. All aboard.
scouts are waiting, Major?
Yeah, we can expect the worst. On the double. Let's be at the church by dawn.
Come out, Trosh. We have the house surrounded. Drop it, Trausch. Ihr zwei geht durch die Stelle. Ihr zwei durch den Heuschuppen.
Das ganze Gebäude durchsuchen. Da hinten.
Sergeant, take two men and search the house. Keep it out of my way. Marla, take this man to the car. Guard him with your life. You better stay with me, just in case she attacks me again.
What will you do with him?
Take him to my headquarters.
May I see him? Oh, please.
Maybe. That depends.
Herr Major, we found a transmitter in a stable.
Excellent.
How's it? Well? Yeah? You call, Herr Major.
Meinecke. Jawohl. Gut. Your father called the pastor of St. Boniface Church. Right after we monitored the transmission last night. He said he had to meet some friends in the church at dawn. Come on.
Roger, you come with me. The rest of you stay here with Kelp. Keep alert. Intrude like this, but we're supposed to meet John Rush here.
No, no, nothing, no. Christ, here come the crowds.
We better get going.
Stay down, you stupid fool. Orders are to stay put, understand?
May I ask how you justify violating a sanctuary in this fashion?
That's a good question, Father. For you to answer. Make sure the men search every inch of the grounds. Go over the church from top to bottom.
Jawohl, Herr Major. Schnell!
All right, Reverend Father. Now let's have the truth.
We know that John Rausch called you last night, right after he radioed secret information to the enemy. Now, what did he want?
It was a private matter, Major.
I warn you, Father. We know that John Rausch set up a meeting here with enemy saboteurs. If you know the whereabouts of the saboteurs and fail to do your duty, I cannot answer for those reprisals that can be exacted from the parish of St. Boniface.
Thank you, Major. You can put your mind at rest. I shall do my duty.
Who are you? What do you want?
We're making arrangements, miss. Could we go inside? It's about your father.
Yes. Yes, this way, please. It was awful. I was asleep. I kept telling Papa no more. They will catch you. They're always all around. Cars, motorcycles, convoys. I was nearly out of my mind. But he wouldn't listen. He had to use his radio again. I tried to stop him, but this morning they came and took him.
Who took him, Janine?
The commandant here, Major Meinecke. A real Boche and a lot of his men. They were all over. I hit him.
The Major?
Yes. I'll never forget his face or his name. Heinrich Meinecke.
Go away. I don't want to see your faces. You American pigs. Why did you help me? Why did I help you?
I see you, fella. In Berlin.
I'll meet you again, Captain.
Not in this war, buddy. And I'll kill you for what you killed in me.
Anything wrong, sir?
No, I just... It's all right. Janine, you know where they took your father?
To the villa. They use for their headquarters. He said that I might be able to visit him.
He what?
He said that I might be able to visit my father.
Janine, your father risked his life to give us information. He told us the Germans were transporting a very important British officer to the villa. That's why we're here, to get him out. Understand?
You mean that you might also be able to save my father at the same time?
With your help.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Hey, why not share the wealth with me?
What does that mean, share the wealth?
It means he'd like a kiss, too.
Oh, I only kiss officers.
Well, that narrows it down somewhat. Come, I'll show you how you can help.
Major Meinecke, please.
Ja, Fräulein.
May I leave my bicycle?
Of course, Fräulein.
fassen! Esel!
So far, so good.
Entirely out of the question. In the eyes of the German command, your father is a criminal.
No.
He admits that he's been passing information on our troop movements to the enemies of the German Reich.
But he was forced. You must take that into account.
I've been taking into account the fact that German soldiers are being killed every day.
Please, measure.
Yeah.
Gefreiter?
Jawohl, Herr Major.
Examine that basket. Take her to the cell of prisoner Rausch. 15 minutes. Stay with her. See that no information is committed. Good day, Fräulein.
Thank you, Major. What did they do to you?
I'm all right. Don't cry, Jeanine.
Marla, Meinecke. The Rausch girl is here. I gave her permission to visit her father. She's now with him. Now, when she leaves, have her followed very carefully. Something's going on. I want to find out what it is.
I could do. Are you okay, Kilp?
I'll survive.
Get rid of that cycle. McIntosh, Duffy, take those German uniforms. Harley, get on that radio. Let's see if your German's as good as you say it is.
Jawohl?
Bist du Gustav?
Ja.
Ist der Rausch schon zu Hause?
Ja.
Ist das Verdächtiges?
Nein, alles ruhig.
Weiter überwachen und falls besondere Vorkommnisse sofort melden.
Jawohl.
Kelp, you come with us. I'll have Jeanine fix your leg. Now, Harley, you get that cycle into the woods and stay close to it in case they call back. Y'all better get a bite to eat. It's going to be a long night. As for you, young lady, while you're saving Kelp's life, you can tell me everything you can remember about the inside of that villa. But everything.
Ein Herzenlein, ein Herzenlein.
Mädchen!
Good girl. Harley, get into that uniform. Give us 5 minutes.
Schaut ihr das an? Der Kerl ist schon wieder blau. Er ist von der Straße hier runter.
Gib mir einen Stoß! Ich stecke fest!
You're right on time, Janine. Let's go. Befehl! We're almost there. Come on. Second now.
Marla, any news of the Rausch girl?
They reported in 2 hours ago, sir. Nothing new.
Get another report.
Come on.
Emergency! Everyone out!
Thank you.
Los! Snel! Snel!
Bloody well timed. What kept you?
Duffy, give him a hand. Where are the rest of your men?
Down that hole. But take it easy. There may be other guards.
We're in the generator room. We're U.S. Rangers. We have 1 minute if we're lucky. Colonel Steele? Look, you haven't got time to play dumb. Weaver's Carbutt's getting here, and it's going to get a hell of a lot worse when we get outside. Now, Colonel Steele, step forward. Colonel James Steele, formerly with the 2nd Fusiliers, get your ass moving.
I'm Colonel Steele.
You come with me. Kelp, take the rest of the men in the army, get guns, ammunition. We're going to catch hell out there. Let's move it.
Come on, men.
This way. Rush.
Wait.
U.S. soldiers on the double. Give us 2 minutes, then follow. McIntosh, tell Kelp to knock out that generator. Then get back here on the double.
Major! Major! Look! Sabotage!
Rangers!
Oh. After the British colonel! Come on!
What's the plan to the Balakas?
Where is
the
here?
Come! Break the two out!
Magnificent, Major.
McIntosh will lead you out. There's a car and driver waiting for you. The driver knows what to do. Good luck.
You're making it possible for me to carry out one of the most important assignments for the Allied forces. Thank you. And good luck to you.
Johnine.
Yes?
You better hurry.
Oh,
mission hours. Move!
Come on! Mein Gott, look there!
British paratroopers.
I knew I'd meet you someday.
Did I kill him?
No, I did. A long time ago.
Did you know him, sir?
Yeah.
Was he a friend of yours?
In war, there are no friends. Just the quick and the dead.